Hey guys, it's Rob. The IO shield covers the cutout on the back of your case and is there to prevent electromagnetic interference from your components, which used to affect analog signals. So with digital outputs these days, is it essential? No. But if you don't want a big gaping hole on the back of your case, you want to install it first thing when building your PC. To install the IO plate correctly, we first need to understand how it attaches itself to a case. See these bumps around the shield? These secure it in place to prevent it from falling out of your case. You need to get the metal panels of your case between these bumps and the plate itself, which requires some force. These prongs on the IO shield help to ground the plate and motherboard, and they do that by touching the motherboard ports. You may need to bend some of the prongs to get them to fit properly. The bigger ones need to go on top of your ports, like this, and the small ones should just be touching the ports to ground them. The better the build quality of the case and IO shield, the easier it is to install. But first, we need to make sure we're inserting it the right way. We start by lining it up with your motherboard. The motherboard goes in this way with the expansion card slots facing downwards, so the plate will face this way. Now, apply force to the corners to get them to click into place. I find it easier to do opposite corners together. Remember, the bumps on the shield need to be forced above the metal brace of the case. You know you've done it right if you can hear the sound of it clacking into place, and you can see the bumps come out on top once it's done properly too. Unable to get the plate in there at all? I've noticed it can be difficult with some poorly built budget cases, like this one. In all instances, it was due to the rear exhaust fan being too close to the IO shield brace. Once I unscrewed the fan, I was able to get the plate in there no problem. Now, place your motherboard down and line up the cutouts with the ports on the motherboard. Push the motherboard against the plate until you see the screw holes of the motherboard match up with the standoffs in your case. No standoffs in your case, you'll need to go back to the beginning and screw those in first. Once you've got your motherboard in the right position, start screwing in your motherboard screws to secure it all in place. If you want to remove your IO shield, an easy way is just to tap it with your fingers from the outside and it will detach itself and fall into your case. That's all there is to it. But if you've lost your IO plate, you can often find a replacement on AliExpress or eBay for around 10 bucks. Just search for your motherboard model number and in most cases, you'll be able to find a replacement. I hope this guide has helped you to get your IO shield in your case, and for more videos just like this in the future, be sure to subscribe and hit that bell icon to be notified on my next video.